A little over a month ago, this terrain received record rains. What was dry and dusty desert has changed to greenery, and what was a huge salt pan has been transformed into an inland sea. Lake Torrens has rarely been subjected to such huge freshwater inflows. Where the bigger salt lake, Lake Eyre, has filled three times this century, for Lake Torrens, this is a first. The phenomenon saw scientists and students from the city scurrying to the bush to analyse this seemingly dead lake. Headed by staff from the Earth Sciences Division of Flinders University, their aim was to collect as much data as possible. Information which in the future could provide the answers to water resource management in what is normally one of the driest areas on this continent.
The point is that it's such a rare event. If it is, as anecdotal evidence suggests, a sort of one in a hundred year event, then scientifically it's just madness not to come along here and measure everything we can while we can.
Immediately to the south of Lake Eyre, which is also filled at a rapid pace, Lake Torrens lies to the west of the Flinders Ranges. It's 170 kilometres long and 80 wide at the widest point. The base camp for the expedition was at the southernmost point, with a second camp at Carrapateena Arm to the northwest. The expedition wouldn't have been possible without support from the army. Apart from the necessary communications between the two camps, at short notice, they also provided ground as well as water transport and, of course, base facilities. Even though this is regarded as a salt lake, it's not all that salty to taste. In fact, measurements taken here show that the salt content is about one-third that of the ocean. And even though there's such a huge mass of water here, at the deepest point, it's under 2 metres deep. Even more remarkably, this is often regarded as one of the hottest places in Australia, but the water here is mighty chilly. The expedition found the level of the water in the southern section of the lake to be still rising. Further north, the lake was found to be shallower, measuring a steady 30 centimetres in depth out from the Carrapateena Arm. From the Eyre, the water looks quite deep, but the eastern side remains mudflat for about 2 kilometres. This is because the fresh water has drained off the ranges, carrying sediments, which are now deposited on that eastern shore. Some scientists say the greenhouse effect could change the nature of these inland salt lakes.
Would it be feasible, or would it be pure fancy to think that you could actually drain the salt out of this lake and just fill it up with fresh water, you know, every few years? It's a long shot, but you never know.
5 years ago, when Lake Eyre to the north flooded, there was an abundance of wildlife. Areas to the south remained dry, and so a variety of birds migrated to the north to breed and some to perish as the salt lake slowly evaporated. Because of the extent of the latest rains, this mass migration of birds hasn't happened. On Lake Torrens, their numbers are not great, but below the waterline, there appears to be no shortage of life. These are just a few of the plankton samples taken from the lake by the research students here. They'll be taken back to Adelaide and put under the microscope and studied by the biologists at the university. They'll be able to compare them with other such creatures from other water systems and perhaps define where these waters drain from and where they go.
Once you know virtually how the environment works, you can then make sensible comments about how to apply and manage the water resources. You can't manage water resources unless you understand the environment in which they occur.
With further rains expected in the coming months, the scientists believe it could be up to a year before the millions of litres of water evaporates from Lake Torrens. It's then just a matter of waiting until the next rains come.